So recently a water bottle company called The Coldest Water asked me if they could sponsor me in a couple of my videos. So this video is sponsored by The Coldest Water. It's a cool water bottle that keeps water cold for an extended period of time, and it does it really well. They told me specifically to make sure I give my actual honest opinion, so I waited before doing this, even though I got it a few days ago, just to see if it worked like they said it would. And it actually works really well, like better than I thought it would. And I've had a couple of things like this before, and this is, in all honesty, like my favorite one so far. So I'm actually really excited about that, because it's cool to be sponsored by something that I actually think is cool, you know? But anyway, thank you. Thank you, Coldest Water, for sponsoring today's video. Huge thanks. And yeah, let's get into this. Today we're going to be reacting to Aerosmith, Janie's Got a Gun. Now, you guys told me about this, right? And also, apologies, if you're new to the channel, my name is Daniel, aka Deathstroke9, and here we react to music, and I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally. But Aerosmith, I've done one song by them, which was Dream On. And in the comments, there were people saying there's a bunch of songs by them that are super popular that you probably already heard before. I don't know. People said that I should have heard Dream On before, and I hadn't, so I have no idea. Since, you know, the name Aerosmith is familiar to me, but I really can't name a song other than Dream On by them. I read through some of the comments in preparation for this video, and I saw some people say that this song was part of their comeback in the 80s. So it's probably a little bit different than Dream On. But at the same time, it's has deep lyrics. So because of that, I was like, all right, I want to check this out. Let me know what other Aerosmith songs I should react to down below in the comments. And thank you very much for joining me. All right, I'm excited to get into this. Let's start. Here we go. Aerosmith, Janie's Got a Gun. There's an official music video. People told me they don't block. People told me they don't block. I'm still going to play it safe as I always do, but we're going to see what happens. 3, 2, 1. Police line, do not cross. I take it this is pretty heavy subject matter, huh? Wow. If I understand what they were saying. Maybe I don't. We're going to look at the lyrics at the end, but let's keep going. That's, oh my. oh yeah, and definitely I can hear the influence of, you know, 80s type stuff. It's still good. It's still good. I still like it. Let's keep going. Got a gun. All day it just begun. Everybody is on a run. Tell me now, it's untrue. for safety. This is crazy, actually. Like, even though I don't love most, I mean, I do like 80s music in a different way than I love, you know, most like 70s or then 90s music, you know. The 80s has a lot of like feel good songs, I guess. There's something about it, and I don't know exactly what it is. A lot of it sounded more poppy and more produced. At the same time, I'm pretty sure I know what he's talking about now. And yeah, huge respect to Aerosmith for tackling this subject. And I'm happy for the protagonist. Although it's sad that he said no one believes her and she has to run away now. So that's awful. But we'll get into that when we finish. Let's keep going. Janie's got a gun. That is some extremely heavy subject matter. Okay. Well, that's interesting. Okay. Let's let me move this up here. Yeah. All right. Whatever. I'll have to do for now. Let's take a look at the lyrics. Thank you very much for joining me, by the way. Let me test this out while we're on camera. Yeah, like I said, this is from 2 days ago, so it's still cold. All right. But yeah. Is it about a dad who abuses his daughter and then she freaking kills him? Because that's what I'm hearing in those lyrics. Not subscribed to them. Let's take a look at these lyrics real quick here. Janie's got a gun is from the 1990. Why did someone tell me that it's an 8? Oops. Okay, whatever. It's from the 1990 Aerosmith album Pump. After thinking about the title, he wrote lyrics inspired by two different stories he read in Time and Newsweek, one involving gun violence within the U.S. towards the end of the 80s, and the other involving sexual abuse of children in well-off suburban communities. The latter story, a young teenager being sexually abused by her father, became a motive for the former, Janie killing someone, in this case, the father. The single went platinum in Australia, shipping over 70,000 units. Number 1 in Australia, number 2 in Canada, number 13 in New Zealand, and peaked at number 4 on the Billboard's Hot 100 chart. Before the track is a 10-second instrumental titled The Water Song, combining sounds of glass harmonica, a wind gong, and bull roars. Interestingly, the bass played at the beginning and during the line Janie's Got a Gun segments isn't an actual bass, but rather the infamous slap bass patch from the Korg M1 with a chorus effect. This same patch was used in many Super Nintendo video games and was even used for the Seinfeld theme, which is probably its best use, known use. The intro provided the premise for the beginning of the video, which is the crime scene after Janie used the gun on her abusive father. Honey, what have you done? It's the sound of my gun. What have you done? It's the sound. Janie's got a gun. What's interesting, he says, what have you done? It's the sound of my gun. So she took his gun, it feels like. Then he says, honey, what have you done? And then he says, it's the sound, but he doesn't finish the second sentence, which makes me think that was that moment. So, Janie's got a gun. Whole world's come undone. Yeah, I can imagine. You know, it kind of destroys everything that they both knew. The whole world's come undone from looking straight at the sun. What did her dad... Yeah, so doing dangerous stuff, staring directly into the sun. What did her daddy do? What did he put you through? Steven Tyler said the title came to him as he played with his piano in the basement. He had just a title until months later when he read on Time about handgun deaths. Oh, so he had the title for a long time. Okay. They said when Janie was arrested, they found him underneath a train, but man, he had it coming. Now that Janie's got a gun, she ain't never going to be the same. Janie's father did something very wrong, and Janie wanted to make sure he would not go unpunished. Hence, she got a way to inflict justice through a firearm. Life was going to change if only because the murder would send Janie to prison. Hence, when she got away, her life was going to change. Yeah, she's never going to be the same. Plus, that, like, can you imagine, like, even if you're abused in that way, in that insanely, intensely personal and horrifying way of it's your own parent, right? You know, like, that's incredibly heavy subject matter right there. Even if that's, you know, that's what's going on, right? Still, to look at the person who's supposed to be, you know, your protector, your caregiver, and your nurturer, and the one who, you know, helps you grow and all, so many different things, you know, so many positive things that are supposed to be, and you have a gun in your hand, and you shoot him dead. How incredibly, like, painful would that be, even to contemplate doing, even though it's... So my point here is that it's such an awful position to be in for our protagonist here. She is in the most horrifying of situations, you know? Like, sounds like a routine abuser. And... Jeez, man. Okay. Well, let's keep going. So next, Janie's got a gun. Her dog day has just begun. Now everyone is on the run. Tell me now it's untrue. What did her daddy do? He jacked? Oh, I'm sorry, my sister just came down here and I didn't want to be saying any of this loudly. All right, she's gone. This is not a sister song. All right. Janie's got a gun. Her dog day has just begun. This is a reference to the movie Dog Day Afternoon, which is itself a reference to the dog days, a sultry time of summer considered to be evil. Also a reference to the old saying, every dog has his day, has its day. Her father had his way for a long time, but this day, because she has a gun, she is in control. He jacked a little bitty baby. Sexually abused a child, presumably, which Janie herself, which is made clear by the original lyric, which, Claire, you can't come down here right now. Please close the door. Okay, I'll be right there. sorry. This is made clear by the original lyric. Oh, he changed it. It was originally raped a little bitty baby. Jeez, this is really heavy. I feel like I should put like a trigger warning at the beginning, but I'm hoping if you're watching this video, you already know what the song is. So, yeah. Anyway, child abuse angle came to Tyler once he heard this woman speaking about how many children are attacked by their mothers and fathers. It was freaking scary. I felt, man, I gotta sing about this. The man has got to be insane. They say the spell he was under, the lightning and the thunder, knew that someone had to stop the rain. The spell he's under is his alcoholism. And references lightning as in white lightning, which is another name for moonshine. The song originally was called Danny's Got a Gun after a close friend of Steven Tyler. It took Steven 7 months to come up with the killer wordplay. Okay. Run away from the pain. Run away from the pain. Yeah, 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 run away. Then there's a guitar solo. The guitar solo was a Chet Atkins-styled guitar. While most electric guitars use steel strings, this one used nylon strings, which is what classical guitars use. Okay. Then repeat of the chorus. Note, if you don't know a Janie, this song might not be the best for an homage. Just ask pre-Captain America Chris Evans here. Okay. Then, what did her daddy do? It's Janie's last IOU. She had to take him down easy and put a bullet in his brain. She said, no, because nobody believes me. The man was such a sleaze, he ain't never gonna be the same. Aerosmith recorded an edited version replacing the lyric with "and left him in the pouring rain." He thought that MTV might ban the song with that violent lyric. He felt MTV was an important outlet for people to become aware of the issue of child abuse and its byproducts. You know, there's a lot of media today that also tries to talk about this. And every time, like, things like that are said, you know, MTV is an important outlet for people to become aware about the issue of child abuse and its byproducts. It's crazy to me. Yeah, I don't know. People to become aware. It's crazy to me that people still need to be made aware of something like that. Like, obviously, there's a moment of realization for, you know, like a kid or something like that. You know, you don't need every child knowing about this type of stuff. But I should think that every adult would understand and know and want to protect their child from anything like this. But, you know, there are some people that are not qualified to be parents out there. She said, nobody believes me. The man was such a sleaze and he's never going to be the same. Yeah, he's not. Yeah, I was kind of like when they said that she, like, when I kind of pieced it together that she shot him, I felt happy for her, to be honest. Janie's got a gun. Her dog days just begun. Now everybody's on the run because Janie's got a gun. Was it daddy's cradle robbed that night? Wow. Made you scream at night. Jeez Louise, this is very dark. All right. Thank you very much for joining me. Let me know what your thoughts on this were. Because, yeah, I understand that all parents aren't perfect, right? You know, like, my parents aren't perfect in any, you know, in any way. I'm not perfect. I think that everyone, you know, there's a moment of realization for a kid when they kind of look up to parents as almost gods or as unfailable people for a long time. And then there's a moment of realization where you're like, all right, they're human beings just like everybody else. They have flaws, they have imperfections, and that's okay, you know? And that's kind of when the relationship shifts a little bit. But at the same time, I wish there were not parents like this, you know? Obviously, this is a song, but stuff like this happens all the time. And it's disgusting. Yeah. All right. Wow. Thank you for joining me. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and all that jazz. And again, let me know down below if there's any other songs by them. I'm sure there's a lot of other songs that you'd like me to check out by them down below in the description. Sorry, I'm all jumbled up. This is a heavy song. Jeez Louise. All right. Now, the last thing that I'm supposed to do with this sponsorship is I'm supposed to tell you about links in the description. Now, I'm going to try to make that as short as possible because, the video doesn't really fit very much. So, on a slightly different note, this is my first time doing a sponsorship like this, and it's pretty exciting for me. And they asked me to choose like a promo code for a link or a referral link. So you're able to get a percentage off your order. Just went ahead and quickly checked that percentage. It's 10% off your order if you use the promo code Legion and use my referral link down below in the description. And, there's also a giveaway that you can check out as well. The product is pretty cool. I liked it, but, you know, don't take my word for it. There's a bunch of reviews and stuff, and it works really well. But anyway, again, not really in line with what we're doing here. So, yeah, and if you or anyone you know has, you know, had something like this happen to them, or if you know anyone who's currently going through anything like this, you need to speak up about it, okay? It's probably hard to do that, and maybe not all situations are exactly the same. There are numbers you can call. There are, you know, hotlines that you need to get you need to get help with situations like that, okay? You don't want to have to, you know, shoot someone, you know? It's pretty crazy. It's crazy out there, man. All right, I'm going to stop. This song's kind of depressing. But thank you for joining me. I'll see you guys soon. Deathstroke 9, out. We are Legion. Stay strong, stay safe, and stay tuned for the next video.